Hello everyone, this is the lecture number 35 of the lecture series of Naval Architecture made for MEO examination. In this lecture, we will continue with the longitudinal stability of the ship. Specifically, I am going to cover a topic, effect of adding a cargo anywhere on the deck on the draft of the ship. Before starting the discussion, let me show one animation. In this animation, I am going to add a cargo forward of the ship somewhere and you will get the new draft at the forward as well as at the aft. Let's see here, the initial draft at the forward and at the aft is D. Then when you are going to add the cargo, I am going to add the cargo at the center of flotation. Then I am going to shift the cargo wherever we want at the forward or at the aft. In this case, I am going to shift the cargo towards the forward side. So before that, please see when you have added the cargo at the center of flotation, what will happen to the draft of the ship. If you see here, there will be an increment in the draft at the forward as well as at the aft. This is called as a parallel sinkage, and because of that there will be an increment in the draft at the forward and at the aft is same. Let's call that increment is X. As this is a parallel sinkage, so you have to add this value in the earlier or older draft. Let's call this plus X plus X at the both the sides. Now I am shifting this cargo forward of the ship. When you are shifting the cargo at the forward of the ship, there will be an increment, let's call that is a Y, and I am going to call this is a plus, and at the aft side, let's call this is a Z, and that is a minus. So take these values and substitute here. At the aft, we have taken minus Z, and at the forward, it is a plus Y. Then if you want to find out the new draft, do the algebraic summation of these all the respective values at the aft and at the forward, then it will be D plus X minus Z, D plus X plus Y. So like this you have to do the calculation for finding the new draft when you are adding the cargo anywhere on the deck. The same thing is applicable when you are discharging the cargo. The only difference will come when you are discharging the cargo from anywhere, that time instead of this parallel sinkage you will get the parallel rise, and instead of adding this value there will be a subtraction of the values from the both the draft. The remaining things will be remain same, depends on whether it is a plus or minus, that depends on from where you are removing the cargo. I hope all of you understood this. We will do one numerical. Again, the picture will be completely clear. A ship 90 meter long is floating at the draft 4.5 meter forward, 5 meter aft. The center of flotation is 1.5 meter aft of the midship. TPC value is 10 tons. MCTC 120 tons meter. Find the new draft. If the total weight 450 tons is loaded in the position 14 meter forward of the midship. So I will always suggest whenever you will get this type of a question, please draw the diagram and show everything in the diagram itself. So this is the diagram which I have drawn here. You can see the length between perpendicular, that is the length of the ship, is given 90 meter. The midship location is here. So from the aft to the midship, the distance is 45 meter. Center of flotation is given 1.5 meter behind the midship. Now the distance of center of flotation from the aft, that is 43.5. 45 minus 1.5, that is 43.5. Let's call this is LA. We need these values when you are going to solve the numerical. Aft draft is given 5 meter, forward draft is given 4.5 meter. Now you have to understand here, the total weight of a 450 tons is loaded in the position 14 meter forward from the midship. So this 450 tons is loaded externally on the ship. So what I told, whenever you are loading the cargo on the deck anywhere, initially you have to keep in your mind that you have added this cargo at the center of flotation, and by using this method find out the parallel sinkage, and then you have to shift the cargo wherever you want to take. So what we will do now, first of all we will find out the parallel sinkage, then we will find out change of the draft because of the trim. Let's do the calculation for this numerical. Now first of all we will do the calculation for finding the parallel sinkage when you are adding the weight at the center of flotation. To calculate the parallel sinkage, the formula will be net load divided by TPC. The net load is 450 tons divided by TPC. If you do the calculation, you will get the value, that is a 45 centimeter. Always keep in your mind, whenever you will get the value by using this formula, whatever the number will come, that will be always in a centimeter. So that you have to convert in a meter, that will be 0.45 meter. Now we will do the calculation when you are shifting the cargo from the center of flotation to the forward of the midship. So first of all, find out the trimming moment generated about the center of flotation. That will be 450 tons, the weight which is added, into the distance of the weight from the center of flotation location, that is 55.5 meter. To do the calculation, you will get this value 6975 by head. In this case, the movement which is generating, it is by head. It means that the forward part will go down and aft part will come up. It means the increment in the draft at the forward will be plus, and at the aft there will be a decrement in the draft. It means that forward draft is increases and the aft draft is decreases. Now once you know the trimming movement, we can easily find out the change of trim, that is a small t, is equal to the trimming movement divided by MCTC. If you substitute all the values here, you will get the number, that is 58.12, that will be always in a centimeter. Convert that value in a meter, that is 0.5812 meter. Now once you know the trim, we need to find out what is the increment and the decrement in the draft at the forward and at the aft. So first of all we will do the calculation. Change of the draft at the aft we are calling with the x. The formula is LA by L into T. Now what is LA? LA is the distance of center of flotation from the aft. L is the total length of the ship. T just now we have calculated. Substitute all these values, you will get the value of x, that is 0.2809 meter. Now we know the equation x plus y is equal to t. If you substitute these values here, you will get the value of y. Now we will do the calculation for finding the new draft. So I will always suggest you have to create the table like this. Older draft, parallel sinkage, change of the draft due to trim. A for aft, F for forward. Everything is given in a meter. So older draft at the aft is F and 4.5 meter. Older draft at the aft is 5 meter and at forward it is 4.5 meter. The parallel sinkage, it is a sinkage, so you have to add both the these values in both the draft, that is plus 0.45 plus 0.45. Then when you are writing the values for the change of the draft due to trim, you have to keep in your mind about the sign conventions. In this case, we have seen that a movement generated because of the addition of the weight is by a head. It means that the forward draft is increases and the aft draft is decreases. So forward draft, that is a value y, we have taken a plus sign, and for the value x we have taken the minus sign. Do the algebraic summation of these values at the aft and at the forward, you will get the new draft at the aft as well as at the forward. Like this, you have to do the calculation when you are adding any cargo on the deck anywhere. Let's do one more numerical for the better understanding of this topic. The numerical is like this. A ship 100 meter long arrives in a port with the draft 3 meter forward and 4.3 meter aft. TPC 10 tons, MCTC is 120 tons meter. The center of flotation is a 3 meter aft of the midship. If 80 tons of the cargo is loaded in the position 24 meter forward of the midship and 40 tons of the cargo is discharged from 12 meter aft of the midship, what are the new drafts? As I suggest, whenever you will get the question, first of all draw the diagram and show all the values on the diagram. Because this diagram is not a part of this question, I have drawn this diagram separately. Let's start the calculation for finding the new draft. Because of addition of 80 tons of the cargo and the removal of the 40 tons of the cargo at a different location. So in this case, how to proceed for that? So first of all, you have to find out the net load. So how to find the net load? Net load is equal to 80 tons of the cargo is added, I am taking the sign as a plus, and 40 tons of the cargo is discharged, I am taking the sign as a minus. If you do the algebraic summation of these two, you will get a plus 40. It means that finally the net load is added. If the load is added, it means that you will get the parallel sinkage. So you have to think that this 40 tons of the cargo is initially added at the center of flotation, and then find out the parallel sinkage corresponding to this. So how to calculate the parallel sinkage? That is, parallel sinkage is equal to the net load divided by TPC. Net load is a 40 tons and the TPC is a 10 tons. You will get the value 4 centimeter. Convert in the meter, that will be 0.04 meter. Now we will do the calculation for the trimming movement. There are two cargoes here. The 80 tons of the cargo is added and 40 tons of the cargo is discharged. Now we will do individually, find out movement generated because of 80 tons of the cargo is added forward of the center of flotation. So you have to take the perpendicular distance from the center of flotation to the load where it is added. So that will be 27 meter. So the movement is 80 into 27. It will be 2160. If you think only about this cargo, the movement generated or the direction of the movement because of the 80 tons of the cargo is in a trim by head condition or trim by bow condition. Now do the calculation for the 40 tons of the cargo which is discharged from the aft of the center of flotation. So 40 tons into the 9 meter, the distance of the cargo which is discharged from there to center of flotation is a 9 meter. So take the movement about the center of flotation, 40 tons into 9, it will be 360 tons meter. If you see here, the movement generated because of the 40 tons of the cargo which is discharged about the center of flotation, the direction will be remain same as that of earlier. In this case also the direction is a trim by head. So the movement direction in both the cases is the same, so you can add both the movements, that will be 2520 by head. Then we have to calculate the change of the trim, that is equal to trimming movement divided by MCTC. Streaming moment is 2520 divided by MCTC is given to us, that is 120. Finally, you will get the value 21 centimeter by head. Convert in a meter, that will be 0.21 meter. Now we got the value of change of the trim, but we have not yet found the value of a change of the draft at the forward as well as at the aft. So let's do the calculation. Change of the draft at the aft, x is equal to LA divided by capital L into T. LA is a 47 meter here. Distance of center of rotation from the aft is a 47. Total length of the ship is 100 meter into trim 0.21. You will get the answer 0.099 meter. We have a second equation, that is x plus y is equal to trim. If you substitute this value of x in this equation, you will get the value of y, that is 0.111 meter. Now we will find out the new draft because of the parallel sinkage as well as because of the change of the draft due to the trim. So you have to create a table like this: older draft, parallel sinkage, change of the draft due to trim, then finally you have a new draft. Aft, after draft, forward draft, everything will be in the meters. So older draft at the aft is 4.3 meter, at the forward it is a 3 meter. We got the parallel sinkage here, so it will be plus sign plus 0.04 meter in both the draft. So how to add? Now change of the draft due to the trim, at the aft we are getting a decrement in the draft, and at the forward we are getting the increment in the draft because the trimming moment is by head, trim by head. So forward draft is increasing and the after draft is decreasing. Do the algebraic summation of the after draft, do the algebraic summation of the forward draft, you will get the new draft. I hope all of you understood this numerical. So in this way you can do the calculation of the new draft when you have added a cargo or discharged a cargo simultaneously from anywhere on the ship. Thank you very much for listening.